Where do the writers of the Grand Ole Opry songs get their inspiration? Well, I guess a good man to ask would be Willie Nelson. You see, Willie is a rare combination, a truly great songwriter who's also an exciting vocalist. And his songs, like all great country songs, are inspired by people and their stories. With such hits as Hello Walls and Crazy to his recent credit, Willie is hotter than a depot stove. Here he is, Willie Nelson.
Well, hello there. My, it's been a long, long time. How am I doing? Oh, I guess that I'm doing fine. Well, it's been so long now, but it seems now that it was only yesterday. Gee, ain't it funny how time slips away? And how's your new love?
How long have you been working on this project?
Well, I hope
it first came to my attention, I guess back fall of 2008, I believe.
I heard you told him.
It was just in the kind of the whispering stage at that point.
That you'd love him till the end of time. Well, now that's the same thing that you told me.
I was commissioned by Capital Area Statues out of Austin, Texas, the nonprofit group of seven prominent Estonians who have devoted their spare time to beautifying the city of Austin. They've commissioned two other pieces previous, one of Angelina Eberle and one called Philosopher's Rock. And their next project was Willie Nelson. So I had been acquainted with one of the board members, Elizabeth Avellan, and she mentioned to me, I want to try this out. So I started working on it. And
I did various models, various designs, different poses, and they selected the one. We just narrowed it down, the one they actually decided upon. We all decided upon it.
Satan,
your kingdom must come now.
Couldn't get more lucky than to have a Willie Nelson piece. I mean, just it's just a tremendous individual he is. I mean, just a remarkable guy. I read that book, The Tao of Willie, to kind of get an inside sense.
You barely make out his left hand right there, resting on the guitar. What these are the ceramic shells. Initially, this was cast in wax from a mold of the sculpture. And then once this coating is on there, they melt out all the wax, hence the lost wax method. This material can withstand the heat of the molten bronze. So the bronze is poured in, then once it cools, you break off the ceramic shell, and you have your bronze piece. So he's all cut up in pieces. It'll be like a quilt. It'll be welded back together again in the bronze.
Oh, it was great when I first started putting the clay on the armature, which is basically a skeleton, because the clay without that would just collapse. So, now just putting the first handfuls of clay on it, scooping this big muddy thing, and the guy snuck over, put the music on, it was Willie. You know, and everyone was just, this vibe was there. It was really an incredible moment, because they're all so excited about this project, everyone who works here. These guys are not even involved, but they just, you know, we're all friends, I've known them for years. So they were just ecstatic. The piece is going to be permanently installed at the new Austin City Limits stage and studio, which is right within the plaza of the new W Hotel, which is right in the middle of Austin. And the clay model was, he'll be about 7.25 feet tall, his final bronze. He originally was about 8.5 feet tall in clay, but there's a shrinkage that takes place for the entire process. The wax shrinks about 5%, and the bronze shrinks about 5%, give or take.
Now inside this chamber, which is being heated, is the actual Willie's bust in there. So you won't be able to make out his face, But you'll see, obviously, it'll be upside down, but you'll see a head and shoulders. So this is being brought to a temperature, and that ceramic, it'll actually be glowing when this is lifted up. So they're gonna move this over here. And then they'll take that metal bathtub-looking contraption, and they'll put it around the ceramic shells that are in here. They'll pour sand in there. That will keep everything stable, and it will also regulate the cooling of the bronze so it doesn't cool too fast, otherwise it'll break the shell and your cast is ruined. And over there is the furnace melting bronze. It has to get to upwards of 2,000 degrees. It looks like lava. It's incredible. And this right here, this is what's called a gate. This is attached to the pieces in wax. What this allows is the bronze to flow out so it doesn't capture any air bubbles. Otherwise, again, your piece is ruined or has to be patched up. That's cut off. This is about 50 pounds right here, at least, of bronze. This is cut off and remelted down. This was originally wax, and they attached the wax pieces to the wax cast. Remember those model kits when you were a kid? Like a model car, a model airplane? Remember how they're all on that sheet? You pick out the little pieces? Well, that sheet, all those looks like tubing, piping, or plumbing almost, that's what they use to flow the plastic around. And remember that, like that line you get on your models or your toys? That's a seam, because the mold is in two pieces. They pop that off, and we have the same thing here. We have to grind that down. I mean, this is a ancient tradition. And there's obviously been innovations over the years, but the principle has been around. The Egyptians were doing this.
Still is still moving to me. I swim like a fish in the sea all the time. But if that's what it takes to be free, I don't mind. Still is still moving to me. Still is still moving to me. And it's hard to explain how I feel. It won't go in words, but I know that it's real. I can be moving or I can be still. But still is still moving to me. Still is still moving to me. La 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 la. I can be moving or I can be still, but still is still moving to me, still, still moving to me. It won't go in words, but I know that it's real. I can be moving or I can be still, but still is still moving to me. 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 Still, still moving to me.